Dad says Lim's cousin Jack is doing his bit on the Lim Van Adams Salvation Project, even though Lim was a criminal and Jack's a cop. Just goes to show you blood is thicker than badges, too.
Minds over singers. Didn't you know that?
Don't matter if they're short, fat, and greasy, they still give up the pussy.
Yeah, but don't they know they're gonna get dogs?
Know it. They want it.
And who knows what women want?
Oh, I know.
Oh, so you got it all figured out.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what do women want, Jack?
Women want you to fuck them in the ass.
Oh my God, you know what? You need help, brother.
A woman wants a man who can take complete control.
Yo, you tripping, cuz.
You know what happens if I go home to Max and say, excuse me, baby, roll over and let me up.
Nah. 3 kids and no daddy, brother.
You don't know, dog. I'm telling you, they're into it. Take my advice. Ride that Hershey Highway. And for the rest of her life, she's yours. Because even if she leaves you, she'll always know.
Always know what, Jack?
That she let you fuck her in the ass.
Oh, okay.
There's been studies.
There ain't been no studies, man.
Cousin, help me out here.
Man, I can't help you with that one, man. I ain't had none in so long, from the front, back, or sideways. I don't remember what the booty looks like.
Oh, damn, that's right. No play the last 2 months of pregnancy.
6 weeks after the kid's born.
Man, 6 weeks is starting to feel like 6 years.
Ooh,
brother, you know what? Let me get you another brew.
Yeah, I second that motion, Governor.
It's the least we can do.
Thanks, fellas, but let's just get out of here.
Yeah, let's get out of here, man.
I think Daddy's home. Yeah, he knew. Hi, Daddy.
Hey.
What up, Jay?
Daddy.
What up with Daddy's little man?
Say hi. Hello. Tomorrow's gonna be so hard.
What's tomorrow?
Going back to work for a few hours.
When were you gonna tell me?
I'm telling you now. Max is gonna keep Jeremiah so you can look for a job.
You tell her before me?
What is the big deal? You knew I'd go back eventually, and it's not like we don't need the money.
Oh, so because we need the money and I ain't making them, my opinion don't mean shit?
Did I say that?
Hey.
Hi.
That. Is he still awake? Did he stay up for his aunt? That's... Yes, he did, with his cute little self. Hi. What is wrong?
Nothing.
Well, nothing sure feels frosty to me.
And what? I'm taking my baby to bed.
Terry, when I say nothing's wrong, that doesn't mean make a smart-ass comment anyway.
It does when you're lying. The opening statements are tomorrow. And Josefina has a federal court date that she can't get out of. I'm presenting the case.
Oh, fabulous. Good for you.
No, Bird. Good for us. When are you going to get off the fence and accept the fact that this trial is happening?
Terry, I am not on the fence, okay? I'm over it. I have a shop to run. Tomorrow's my first day back. Sorry.
Bird.
What?
Please, Bird, listen to me. I need your support. Hardy has fired his old lawyer. He got Ginder Jones. This is major representation. It would be a whole lot easier if my sisters were in that courtroom.
What time?
9:30.
1 hour, and then I have a 11 o'clock appointment.
Counsel, may it please the court. Terry Joseph for the plaintiffs. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, thank you so much for being here. And I don't want to mince words or waste your time. This is a case about deceit. The defendant lied, and he stole. But he lied to the best friend he ever had. And he cheated him out of his livelihood. And he stole his pride. It's too late to give Jeremiah Joseph back his pride. or his best friend, or even his life. But you, and only you, can compensate the Joseph estate for Jeremiah Joseph's losses and return to it the defendant's deceitful gains. Thank you.
Ginder T. Jones for the defendant, Your Honor. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, if you're anything like me, you enjoyed Ms. Joseph's presentation. But entertaining as her presentation was, it's not evidence. The evidence will show that Jeremiah Joseph was not cheated. In fact, it will show that he got more than he deserved. In fact, it will show that Jeremiah Joseph was a man of low moral character. In fact, he was well aware of the value.
Can he do this?
Shh.
And in fact,
she just asked a question.
Max, diminished, it was because of the shameful behavior of Mr. Joseph.
Now,
Ms.
Joseph, isn't there something you can do? Objection or something?
No, Max, his opening statements. He has to go through.
Yeah, but he's just railing on Daddy like it's.
I told you this was going to be.
Just a moment. Just counsel approach.
How you doing, Miss Joseph? You okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
No, you're not fine. And you're going to take a definite turn for the worse if you keep having side talk during opening statement in my court.
Yeah, it is very distracting, Your Honor.
I apologize, Your Honor.
Don't apologize. Just control your damn client.
Step back.
Man, I like how you lived. You getting used to this?
Shit, man. I can't wait to get out of here.
No luck from your landlord?
Man, I don't even want to talk about it. Thanks for coming by.
No problem.
I appreciate you hooking me up.
You got it. Remember, this is only temporary.
Temporary J.O.B. is better than no J.O.B.
True. Her name is Vicky Wu. You got her address. She's expecting you.
Thanks, Jack.
Get up.
I'll call you and let you know how it went.
Aunt Bird's a really cool boss. And all the stylists who rent chairs in her beauty shop love her. But like any boss, Aunt Bird has rules. No rap music, no TVs, and last but definitely not least, trash cans have to be kept empty. As you can see, my auntie hasn't been around in a while.
Is there anyone available to do my hair?
Hi, girl. How you doing?
It's so great. How you doing?
How you doing?
Hey, girl. Is that a cake for me? Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, wow. So, cut the cake. Lita, is that a new radio station?
I mean, I like rap music, but you know,
we knew. And I know that is not a TV in my shop. Sorry. Hi, Naomi.
The woman in the blue dress may not look like much to anyone else, but she's one of my Auntie Bird's regulars. Or used to be.
But I'm sorry.
That's all right. I've only been doing Naomi for 3 years. I go away for a couple months to have a baby.
It's not like that at all. She came in one day looking a mess.
And you knew I was coming back today, but here you are doing her hair.
I don't blame you for being upset.
I'm not upset.
I'm not upset. Let's go have some cake. Come in.
Oh, shit!
Close the door. What's your name?
Len Van Adams.
Who sent you?
Jack Van Adams.
You did a bullet in half in Stateville?
Yeah.
My bad. It's like this. I paid you. I tell you where I'm parked. You stop by. Pick up the credit card. Check it out.
Look, I don't know what the hell is going on.
I'm not finished, all right? The banks have a system. They ain't stupid, but they are slow. Once the card's activated, you have 2 hours to shop till you drop. You page me, I tell you where I'm parked, you bring this shit over, you get 10% of retail, and you're done.
Now I'm finished.
Speaking. Hi. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, we could definitely reschedule. No, it's not a problem. Okay. Bye bye. Oh, not a problem at all.
Three 15. Magic time. School's out for another day. Till this very moment, Dad's new truck was so cool. But I knew what Mike was thinking. Unless I could prove Mercedes or Lexus made a tow truck, I was gonna get clowned, dogged, and dissed.
What's up, son?
Yeah.
Hey, you all right?
Yeah.
Good. Huh, this is a pretty narrow street. I'm gonna have to go back around.
Great. That way anybody who missed it would get a chance to see Ahmad in a big old tow truck show.
Why you wanna do me like that, man?
Sit down, cousin. Go on, sit down. Look. Vicky works with the department sometimes. It buys us some favors.
They're stolen credit cards. Her favors don't mean shit.
Hey, nobody's getting pickpocketed or robbed here. Vicky jacks credit profiles from her computer. They're good until the bank flags them. Even after that, the cards should just get refused. Nobody's gonna call the cops on you and get up in your face.
What about the FBI? They're checking for stolen credit cards too, right?
Secret Service.
Shit.
They're overrated, man.
Fuck overrated. I get hemmed up again. That's the second strike. That's 10 years, Jack. 10.
But it'll put food on your table until you find something better.
Is Franco in this?
Franco don't know shit about this. I love my brother, but he's too high profile to fuck up a good thing.
You mean an illegal thing? Pretending you on the up and up. You ain't no different than me.
Hey. Me and you ain't got nothing in common, okay? I work for a living. I put motherfuckers like you away.
Then why you doing this?
Because you're my mom's favorite nephew. And I ain't got nothing but love for you.
I can work legit, Jack. That's all I'm saying.
I know that. I know that. Like I said, it's only temporary. Okay? Besides, the only people getting hurt in this scam is the insurance companies, and fuck them.
Heard that.
If Vicky got a little something going on, though, huh?
She is fine.
That shit is nice, too, dog.
Didn't.
Oh, no. I never hit it.
You hit it.
She works that shit all night, cuz.
Man.
That could be you too, Lamp.
Nah, man, I don't fuck around.
Bullshit. You gotta fuck around. It's a scientific fact.
Man, your mother dropped you on your head when you was a baby. Where you get all this fucked up philosophy?
All right. I'm schooling you, cuz. You're not trying to hear this on you. I'm out.
Peace, man.
Yeah.
Hey, babe. How was the trial?
Hey, I didn't stay for much of it, but Max called to say I didn't miss a thing. Baby, come here. You know, I'm really sorry I didn't check with you before I went back to work. You know, I would never disrespect you.
I know.
So we all right?
I'm all right. You fine.
Emma?
Yeah. Question. Me, Jack, and Kenny were out the other night.
Talking about what women want.
Oh, boy. What y'all out there talking about something you don't know nothing about?
I know about this, though.
Yeah? What else you know?
A little massage oil is upstairs. How about we go upstairs and you break me off a little something, something? It's been 7 weeks since you had Jay.
How about you slow your roll? I haven't even been to the doctor yet. Besides, after today, even if I could, I'm just...
So, tell Daddy all about it.
Lim, I think I'm gonna have to start all over. You know, I take all that time off, and I go back to work today, and I feel like a stranger in my own shop.
Babe, it'll be fine once you get back into your groove.
What groove? All my regulars are now somebody else's regulars.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay. Doing hair is my thing. Can't nobody do it like I can. I realized how much I missed it today.
Damn. I never heard you break it down like that. I always thought it was just a job.
When a woman's hair looks good, she feels good about herself. And I feel good when I can make that happen.
Oh, yeah? Mm. Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. So, pretend you're doing my hair. What would you say?
I see some bald patches, Mr. Van Adams. You might want to go get some Rogaine.
Oh, really? Rogaine, huh?
Yeah.
I got your game.
If it please the court, the plaintiff calls Mr. Cassius Whitney.
Going up there and lie like a rug.
Sorry, it's fine.
The whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
Mr. Whitney, did you keep the books for the businesses owned by Jeremiah Joseph and the defendant from the start?
Yes, ma'am.
For how long?
24 years.
And Mr. Whitney, why did you leave?
Hardy Lester fired me. Said he could do a better job on the books himself.
Should have fired him from day one.
Well, did he complain about the way you were doing the books before firing you?
Not once.
Achoo!
And when you were dismissed, was it before or after he bought out Jeremiah Joseph?
Three months before.
Okay, we're on the water right now. Bye.
You hit Louisiana, then Atlanta, Indiana. Forget a city, sugar got country grammar. And yo, we going places where my sound scan ain't tough. So when I say I ain't Norio, it ain't that rough. I need you, Jake, in my face, asking all this stuff. I gotta keep my mouth shut and don't say what. But yo, it's hard to. Knuckleheads got the heart to. Yo, from New Orleans, LA, VA to Queens, the I-95. Now we hit the Philippines, but now it's different. We gotta stay sober. Yo, communicate, Star Tech, Motorola. Keep it on the hot tubs. Don't talk too much, dog down entertainment. You know we touch, all our whips got navigation. While your whips is just guard patient, is you knowing what you're facing?
Jeremiah Joseph was bought out. There was no one there to advise him on how much his half of the business was worth, other than the defendant. Is that right?
That's right.
So, Your Honor, may we approach?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Counsel is deliberately distracting the jurors from my witness's testimony.
What are you talking about?
Oh, give me a break. The sneezing, the coughing.
I have hay fever.
Oh, my God. Well, what about the pens and the briefcase? What, do you have butterfingers, too?
Miss Joseph, grow up. Step back.
Yo.
Hey, Ken, it's Lem. What's up?
Hey, Lem, thanks for hitting me back, man. You know, man, I need a favor. Yeah, well, Max isn't back from our court yet, and I got to make
so can you pick up Amon from school for me?
Yeah, no problem. I'll head out now.
All right. Good looking out, bro.
Bird, I'm seriously jammed up, or I would never ask this.
What is it?
I'm 45 minutes late for my next client. So can you wash your head for me?
Sure, no problem.
It's Maya.
Maya.
No problem. I feel weird. Washing heads is how you started me. And Maya was your client and everything.
Hey, man. No problem.
I caught hell in traffic, man. Sorry I'm late.
At least it's you.
What's that supposed to mean?
None.
You don't want your dad picking you up?
No. I mean, yeah. Can we drop it?
Yeah? You in a hurry to get home?
No. Why?
Because I ain't whipped on your little butt in a while. Video games or basketball?
Man, it don't matter. I school you in both.
Oh, what's on now?
Man, you don't want none of this.
Oh, I got something for you.
You better keep it to yourself.
Good. How's that baby?
Oh, he's good.
Good. And that fine husband of yours?
He's good.
Can I tell you something? I miss you doing my hair, Bird.
Lena's great. Nobody does a better rap.
Oh, she all right, but she never gets the left side right.
Well, you know you can always come back.
You know she got 5 kids and no man.
Tell me about her.
Take that, little man.
Dang. HR. She still got HR and stuff.
Just wait. Oh, yeah, what's up with you at school? I bet her brother feels like Kunta Kinte up in there.
It's all right. Shoot. Got HR.
What's the deal between you and your dad? You mad at him or something?
Nah, we cool.
Come on, dog. You know I'm not gonna tell nobody your business.
It's just that everybody else is riding up in new cars. Why I gotta be in a tow truck? Man, if Mike says one more thing about it...
I feel you, Amon. Thing is, you gotta see the truck for what it really is. It's really payback for doing the right thing, for working hard, making sacrifices for the family. The truck says your dad's the kind I wish I had. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Mr. Lester, who suggested the buyout?
He did.
And who set the price of the buyout?
He did. Said he needed 20 grand just to keep him from nailing his legs to the railroad tracks.
And at that time, did you believe that that was a fair price for his half of the business?
Yes, I did.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lester. Mm-hmm. I know how difficult this must be. Mm-hmm. I have nothing further.
Miss Joseph Cross?
Thank you. Mr. Lester, now, is it your testimony that you were running the business single-handedly?
I did everything.
You managed the inventory all by yourself.
Darling, everything means everything.
And does everything include underpaying Jeremiah Joseph as a revenge for not being the kind of partner you wanted him to be?
I paid the man what he asked for. Ain't my fault the man's stupid, irresponsible. His daddy was the same way, and his daddy before that. It's just bad blood. The man's got sinning just running through his veins.
The hell do you think you are? You cheating, stealing, evil son of a bitch!
Bailiff, remove her right now.
We are losing this case, Terry, because you won't put me on the stand.
I'm not losing, Maxine.
Well, if it's not you losing, then the lady in the Terry mask is getting her ass kicked.
All right, fine. You want to go on the stand? Fine, we'll do it right here.
I'm not playing with you. I will do it in court like everybody else.
Everybody else gets prepped. If you can't do it here, you can't do it in court.
I can do it.
Go ahead. Miss Chadway, do you have information supporting the claim that the defendant defrauded Jeremiah Joseph?
Yes, I do. Like I've been telling you. Hardy Lester listed the value of the store at $400,000 in his books in the same year as the buyout.
Okay, fine. How'd you come about this information?
When I was little, I used to pretend I was running a store, and Hardy would play along and let me write in the books. I remember $400,000 next to value of the business.
Now I'll be the other side.
Oh, please, give me a break.
No, you said you could do it.
Okay, go ahead. Play a little game.
Okay. Miss Chadway. Are you absolutely certain you remember $400,000 in the books?
Positive.
If I told you that value doesn't appear in the books the year of the buyout, you'd still be sure?
I know what I saw, Terry.
long ago was that? 15 years?
Yes, but I still remember.
Do you remember who was the president then? What did you get for your birthday?
I don't know.
And do you remember who was your school teacher that year?
I can't remember.
You don't remember any of those other things from that time. Yet you want a jury to believe that you remember the one fact that entitles your family to hundreds of thousands of dollars. That's why I won't put you on the stand.
Hey.
Hi.
Ready to go?
Yeah, just give me 1 second.
You want to hear some good news?
Please.
I found a job.
You did not.
It's down at the docks.
The docks? Mm. A longshoreman? I thought you needed to be in the union.
You do, so they're paying me in cash under the table until I can build up enough points to join the union.
Baby, this is so terrific. When do you start?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Oh, shit, my fool got a J-O-B. How come you didn't tell me?
I didn't want to build up your hopes. I figured I'd keep it to myself until I knew it was real.
I'm so proud of you.
Mwah. I knew that you would be.
You okay?
Yeah. I just need you to hold me.
Oh, well, you know I can do that. Come here. My baby. You say if I ask you, to let me slip it in that other hole
in my ass, I'd say try it, and my kids won't have a daddy.
Well, that's what I thought.
Where did all that come from anyway?
Nowhere, baby, nowhere.
It's not bad enough I get reamed by my sister. Now you want to rip me a new one.
Okay, baby. You know, why don't we
Terry did not have to do all that. Always got to show everybody up, be the smartest one around.
Yeah,
makes me sick. What?
What? I didn't say anything.
But you got something to say.
Baby, come on. Why don't we just go upstairs?
Kenny. What?
Maxine Terry is right. No, yeah, listen to me, all right? Now, she's a lawyer. Your lawyer. You know, she should call the plays. But baby, why don't you just, you know, take a little step back and let her do her thing, all right?
Oh, Max, not today.
I'm not here to jump on you, okay? I made your job harder than it had to be, and I didn't mean to. I'm proud of you. You're my sister, and I got your back.
Well, So you're saying... Okay.
Cool. You had breakfast?
No, I'm gonna get something on the way.
How about
court.
I do you up some eggs instead?
Oh, you don't have to.
I want to, if you feel like it.
I feel like it. Thank you.
Good. Mm. It's a shame it all came to this. I really did love Uncle Hardy. Got my jollies writing in that big green ledger. And now, just never know. You never know. Okay, excuse me for a second. I need to make a phone call.
Okay.
2,788 dollars. Damn.
Well, that ain't gonna make it. 10% is not enough with me taking all the risk.
10%'s what it is, baby Baba.
It's 30 if you want the stuff.
Is that right?
That's right. Oh, you wanna rock? We can rock. I'm all about business. What you wanna be about? And tell your man to step back.
Clarence Chill. 15%.
20.
All right. My brother, my brother.
Defense rest.
Will you be presenting on rebuttal, Ms. Joseph?
Yes, Your Honor. The plaintiff recalls Mr. Cassius Whitney.
Why in the hell they call that old fool back?
I'll see you later. I'm going to court.
Excuse me.
Hi.
Hi.
How can I help you?
Do you take walk-ins?
Actually, I'm about to leave, but maybe, Romeo, can you take another appointment?
Mm-mm. Oh, you got the concert, right?
Yeah, you know what? I'll do it. I can do it.
Thank you.
Sure.
I need a change.
No problem. I'm Tracy. They call me Bird.
Fatima.
Nice to meet you. I love that name. So, do you know what you might want, Fatima?
Maybe... I really don't know.
Let me take a jacket. Thank you. Well, here is a book. There's some great new looks in here. So flip through it and see if there might be something you like, okay?
Okay.
Sweetie, you want to take this? Let me show you something. See that? Something like that might look really good on you.
You really think so?
Oh, yeah.
Is the defendant the kind of man who would get Jeremiah Joseph drunk just to get the store away from him?
Objection, Your Honor. Calls for speculation.
Offer to impeach the defendant's own character testimony.
You opened the door, Mr. Jones. Overruled.
Yes. That store is Hardy Lester's life. He would do just about anything to have it all to himself.
See that? Grabs in the basket.
Do you believe Jeremiah Joseph was the kind of man who would sell his half of the store for 10 times less than it was worth, even if he were drunk?
Not for a minute.
He would insist on seeing the store's books. Isn't that right? When you were fired, did you leave empty-handed?
Not exactly. I got a severance. Thanks to Jeremiah. I knew Hardy didn't cotton to it, so I made a copy of the books. Just in case he got into one of his moods and decided to come after me and say that I stole.
This is the defendant's Exhibit 3. Obtained by us in discovery and entered into evidence by the defendant. May I approach the witness?
Mm-hmm.
Here you go. Does this look familiar?
No.
In fact, the store's accounting was kept in a green book, not a red one, like this one. Isn't that right?
Yes.
So if Jeremiah Joseph was shown this red ledger, what would the value of the store have been?
Achoo! $40,000.
And if he had seen your books, Mr. Whitney, what would have been the store's value?
Mr. Jones, either excuse yourself or shut the hell up. Continue.
$400,000.
Plaintiff offers into evidence Mr. Whitney's accounting records as Plaintiff's Exhibit 9.
Sidebar, Your Honor. Not only do these records lack foundation, but they are acknowledged duplicates that are in clear violation of the best evidence rule.
I just laid foundation, and it is the best evidence when the originals have been withheld or destroyed due to fraud.
What are we supposed to do? Take this man's word for it that he made this ledger from the original? What if he said pigs fly? Would you make a flight reservation?
You know, you're really funny. You should take this act on the road. I say that we give Mr. Whitney's ledger to the jury and let them decide.
I agree.
Your Honor, you can't...
Watch me. Step back. The court admits Mr. Whitney's accounting ledger into evidence as Plaintiff's Exhibit 9.
Want to talk about it?
I don't think I can.
It's all right. I just figured if I knew why you needed a change, then maybe I could do something with your hair to help that out.
So you're that good, huh?
Oh, I am that good.
Then why was your chair empty when I walked in?
Because I had a baby. Oh. I've been gone. But I'm back now.
Good.
Well, I answered your question. Now what about mine?
7 years together, and I see him on the streets with her. Barely 4 months since we split up. Our divorce isn't even final yet, and she's got this big, huge rock on her finger.
That's wrong.
I thought we were happy. They stopped talking. Didn't want to have sex.
You should have known something was wrong right then.
Yeah, I guess I should have. I was too fat. Wasn't pretty enough, you know.
This... Girl, no. Don't nobody tell you what you are. Your worth comes from you. You have a special, true place inside you that can't nobody touch. Especially some asshole who doesn't know the meaning of commitment or how to work it out.
Yeah.
Shoot. Look at you.
I am so happy I came here today.
So am I.
Tag. I should have worn my Jordans. I gotta get up on that truck and be gone before anybody can clown me.
Hey, Amon!
Or I can just open up a can of beat down on Mike.
Wait up, Amon.
Why are you stepping up to me, Mike? You wanna fight again?
We fought last week. I'm tired of fighting. You?
I'm tired if you're tired. So what's up?
Think your dad'll take some of us for a ride in that cool truck?
I don't know.
Please, man.
Maybe later.
Okay. But I'm up first, right?
What's up?
Hey, big man. How'd it go today?
Good.
You know, I talked to your principal today. And he said you were killing the books.
Yeah?
I said, of course. He's a Chadway.
Guess sometimes when you're feeling low, you have to check yourself. Because if you don't, you can beat a man and not even know it.
In the matter of the estate of Jeremiah Joseph versus Lester, how do you find?
We find for the plaintiff.
Yeah!
And award the plaintiff half ownership of the store, plus $242,000 in lost profits.
Ooh, cool. I'm talking about... Mr. Lester, the court directs you to deliver a true and correct set of store keys to the plaintiff within 5 business days.
Deliver keys to my store?
Half yours now. And if I hear you didn't hand them over, you'll enjoy the inside of a jail cell until you do. Mm-hmm. Thank you, members of the jury. We are out of here.
Oh, you are the lawyer.
I'll call you first thing on Monday morning. We'll take care of it, all right?
Good. That's what I'm talking about.
Miss Joseph.
Yes.
Nice job. Congratulations.
Thank you. You know, if you spend half the time preparing your case as you do on stupid tricks, you might... What am I saying? I'd still kick your ass.
Thanks.
Have a nice day.
Take care.
Here, girl, here's your glasses.
Let's find some place to go eat and celebrate.
You too, but you just make such a scene.
You know, there was a... time when I loved you girls like you were my own. Now look what you've gone and done. Hmm?
Yeah.
I Think I'm beat, huh? Still got an assault case. They can give me an extra $300,000. I'll be back. I'll be bringing the devil with me, too.
What's up, babe?
Hey.
Oh, great, another bill.
Yeah, but look who it's from. The doctor. He seems to think I'm ready to resume a normal sex life. What do you think? Got some catching up to do. For you to be honest with me. I'm correct in everything you say and everything you do and believe. I'm gonna be all those things for you too.
Go through all the pain back then, yeah, yeah. I had faith it would be you. The earth nourished our roots to grow again.